I think over time there's been a bit of confusion about what a do not resuscitate order really means. When we're discussing do not resuscitate, we're really just talking about the process of obtaining CPR, cardiopulmonary resuscitation, or not obtaining cardiopulmonary resuscitation. Folks who choose to have a do not resuscitate DNR order have made a conscious choice about whether they would want CPR to occur to them or not. It does not mean that they won't necessarily get other symptomatic treatments. It doesn't mean that they won't get, for example, antibiotics for a pneumonia or a blood transfusion for a low hemoglobin. I mean, it's so dependent on the patient and the case, but it's really just talking about that CPR component. Where we're coming from when we're having the DNR conversation is that for certain patients at a certain stage in their illness trajectory, the process of having CPR may lead to a quality of life that's not ideal, that's not optimal, both because of the process of CPR and what it entails, but also because of the statistics that show that for many patients, CPR will not work if they have a particular disease or if they're at a certain stage of disease. So that's where healthcare providers are really coming from, and it's really a quality of life discussion about a binary decision, but it's not necessarily associated with other palliative treatments, and I think sometimes that can get a bit confused.